Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Friends, today we are going to learn a tutorial on cash burn rate and we'll be discussing an example on Snap IPO. So let's get into the nitty-gritty of the same. See, cash burn rate, from the name itself, cash burn rate, we can understand that what cash burn rate is all about. In simple term, cash burn rate is how quickly the company spends the cash or cash due to negative cash flows, but we need to understand it deeply. So in this regard, we'll go through the meaning of the burn rate, when it happens and how it is being calculated and more. Let's see some diagram graph on the same. This is the cash burn rate of, as you can see over here, Snap's cash burn rate and revenue shortfall resulting in the share price. So this is the detail of the share price going down from September 17 to November 17. It is coming close enough to 15.15. So the rate at which the cash is being burned by the company is called the cash burn rate. Now, why it is important? See, burn rate isn't very critical in case of companies that are doing quite well. However, for the companies that have just got started, you can say don't have many sales yet. So understanding the cash burn rate is important. See, burn rate is applicable especially to those companies whose cash flows are running negative. If the cash flows are running negative, then that is important, which is not positive. By calculating the cash burn rate, the companies who are running negative on cash flow would understand how long they would be sustainable. Okay, and that means that burn rate is the measure. It is a measure for the sustainability of the company. On the basis of the cash burn rate, the financing options of the company will be decided upon. When we look about the graph over here, we note that Snap's Inc. share price have declined closely to 40% of the IPO of 24.48, and it has dropped down to 15.15 currently. This is primarily due to high burn rate and missed revenue targets. You can see 15.15 over here, and this is primarily due to high burn rate and missed revenue targets. We will look into the Snap's cash burn rate and how it is calculated later in a post scenario. Now, why is the cash burn rate very important for the investors? Yes, absolutely. If you're a startup, okay, then in that scenario, the investors may be having a glance at you at the very first end. Guess for what they are calculating? You're right. They are ascertaining the burn rate of your startup. The investors look at the two factor to come to conclusion regarding the burn rate. The first thing that they look upon the companies is the revenue, okay? And the next thing is and then they find out the forecast, okay? So these are the two things. If the revenues of the company are growing as rapidly as per the forecast or more, the investor decide to invest in the company. And if not, then they look at the other startups for the right opportunity. So while you can say that while you're looking at your burn rate, two things should always be kept in mind. Your sustainability is greatly decided by the burn rate. Again, this sustainability will be very important in our discussion right now. And it is decided by the burn rate. If the cash is burning more rapidly than the revenues, then your sustainability is really at stake. So that is really a big question. Secondly, the investors are always at a lookout for your startup and how it has been performing. So you need to take steps to take care of the burn rate to attract the right investors to your company. But how to calculate the cash burn rate? See, here's the way to calculate the cash burn rate. All you need to do is to follow the simple step. See, step number one is, in the first step, you would need to zone the, you can say, in the period of the time during which you calculated cash burn rate. For example, let's say that you want to know the cash burn of your startup during the first quarter, let's say January to March. So in that scenario, you need to look at the opening cash balance. That is the opening cash balance at the beginning of the time and of the time at the closing balance at the end of the period. And in our example, we would look at the opening cash balance as on 1st January and we'll look at the end balance as on 31st March. So let's say the 1st January balance is close enough to $20,000 and the 31st March, that is after 3 months, is let's say $11,000. So what this that means that during the 3 months, your cash has burned around how much? That is from 20,000 to 11,000, which gives us 9,000. So cash burn rate, this was the step one. The step two is basically to calculate. Now you need to take the second step. All you need to do is to divide the differences between the opening balance and the ending balance by the number of months. So in our example, the number of months over here for the period is 3 months, right? And the difference is how much? difference is sir, it's 9,000. So that means the cash burn for the period of the startup would be 9,000 divided by 3 months, which is 3,000. Now let's understand some of the relevance regarding revenues in cash burn. See, how would you understand whether the cash burn rate is low or high? So this comes with the relevance of the revenue. And once you calculate cash burn rate, you need to look at your sales. Very important. So sales will play a major role in this. Are your sales more than your burn rate? So in our example, if you go to see, the sales of the startup for the period should at least be 3,000 or more. Okay, it should be 3,000 more. Otherwise, it isn't a good position to be in. Now let's take a practical example to calculate the cash burn rate and illustrate this. Let's see how things work out. Let's say there is a company called Ding Dong. Don't laugh. Ding Dong Inc. is a startup company. It is aiming for venture capital funding. Thus, it wants to look at its cash burn rate for the last quarter of the year. So there are some following information regarding that case. The following info: the cash flow at the beginning of the quarter is let's say $45,000. Okay, that is $45,000. And in the end, let's say it is $15,000. Since the business has been completely dry, Ding Dong sell for the quarter has been just 30,000. So 30,000 is your sales. Now, is it enough for the startup company to remain sustainable? You need to compare the cash burn over here. So this is a very simple example. All we need to do is just to follow these steps, the step-by-step process, to first ascertain the cash burn rate, and then we will compare with the sales. So the first step is to compute the difference between the beginning cash balance and the ending cash balance. So the beginning cash balance, I'll just find a difference for you. The beginning cash balance is what? 45,000. The ending cash balance is 15,000. So the cash burn is to the extent of 30,000. Now we need to divide the difference with the number of months in the period to find out the burn rate. So the cash burn of Ding Dong during the last quarter will be for 3 months, right? Because it's quarter. So you can say the cash burn of Ding Dong during the last quarter will be 30,000 divided by 3, that will be 10,000. So it has been mentioned that the cash flow for the company has been dry due to the last quarter, and it could only make revenue of around 30,000 during that time. That means that the revenue for each month, will be $10,000 as well. So since the cash burn is over here 10,000, we can easily say that Ding Dong is not in a very good position. So to be able to attract the venture capital funding, it has to improve its sales and cash flow. See, it is currently in a situation where the cash burn and the cash inflow are exactly the same. That means that what the organization has been earning, it's burning right away. Now let's see how the calculation of the snapping cash burn rate has been worked out. Let's see their cash flow statement, that is cash flow from the financing activities, and see what exactly has been going on over there. See, close enough to let's have a look. Now, as you can see over here, this is the cash flow statement. We know that how to calculate the cash burn rate. Now it is very easy for us with examples. So let us apply our knowledge in snappings. In March, snappings raised over 2.6 billion. By the way of IPO, giving it an overall valuation of 20 billion. So over here, the proceeds from the exercise of the stock is 206,579, because over here the repurchase has been done. Proceeds from the stock options 594. Proceeds from issuance of Class A common stock in initial public offering, and the net of the underwriting commission is 265,7797. That is close enough to 2.6 million. So in this scenario, the proceeds from the issuance of the preferred stock, nothing is there. Payment from initial public offering 5024, which gives us the final amount as 244,788. So that gives us final value as 142,7114. So a significant amount of money was raised by snapping and was invested in what? Marketable securities. So this is how it was. It had spent. Let's see how the amount was been invested, and that we can only observe in the investing. That is the cash flow from the investing activity. This is cash flow from the financing activity, because the main thing to observe was the amount that is raised by IPO. Now let's look at the amount of the purchase of the marketable security, which is 142,3214. So you can see so much amount of has been invested in marketable securities, the amount raised and the amount invested. You can see the difference. So let's look at the cash position as on the 31st March of Snap Inc. And let's observe what goes around over there. See, the current assets, leave it that. Cash and cash equivalents over here was 142,7114. The marketable security that has been purchased is 1815,442. So you can make a comparison over here that the cash position over here, that is the cash and cash equivalents of Snap Inc. is equal to 142,7114 plus 1815,442. That gives you final 324,2556. So please note that I'm adding marketable securities here, as the company has invested a sizable portion of its IPO money in the same, because this will help us correctly calculate the cash burn rate. See, as you can see over here, the calculation has been done. Okay, the cash positions, okay, 324, whatever the amount that we have just found out. Now if you see the cash and cash equivalents as on September, it is just 317,554. The amount has been majorly invested in marketable securities. So the cash and cash equivalent as on the September 2017 plus marketable security as on September 2017, that will give you the cash position of Snap Inc. The cash position as of the Snap Inc. of September 2017 is going to be what? The 317,554, that is the cash and cash equivalent, plus the amount of marketable security that has been invested. So that gives the final amount as 2,098,068. So as you can see, the cash burn rate of the Snap Inc. in 6 months, that is from 31st March until the 30th September, 31st March till 30th September 2017 is the cash position as on the 30th September 2017, less the cash position as on the 31st March. So just input the numbers. Let's see. 229,068 was the number for, it was for September, and 556 was the amount for the March. So you can see how much the cash has been burned. That is 944,488 million. So that is the amount that has been burned. Literally, there is a cash burn over there. You can see the negative amount that has got involved in this particular scenario. So cash burn of Snap Inc. in 1 month, because this is for 6 months, right? If you divide by 6, you get this amount as for the 1 month. So you can say 157 million per month was the amount being, that is the amount that has been cash that has been burned for Snap Inc. So this is how we have taken the example for Snap Inc. also. And that is it. I hope you have got a real great idea regarding the cash burn ratio. Thank you, everyone.